characters are role-playing as superheroes as opposed to fantasy characters. And it looks a lot like it's probably going to be satirizing the Marvel versus DC arc. At least that's my observation. I'm very interested. I loved the first game. I played it several times. I'm a big fan of South Park, so I'm ready. Let's see this. I will say I appreciate that they delay games based on the quality of it to ensure that it's shipped as a decent product. Ubisoft, maybe you should think about doing that a little bit more than just with the South Park game, with the people who make South Park at all. Look, complete, uncompleted game. Start completely complete. Number four is Horizon Zero Dawn. This is a post-apocalyptic game where you're sort of a hunter. It looks a lot like it might not be futuristic until you see what you're hunting. It's a robot animal, and it looks like the machines won, so to speak, during the course of the apocalypse. And it's a game that I personally got very excited when I first saw it, when they announced it and showed all the footage from the sort of early versions of the game. And in a lot of ways, sort of subverts a lot of the tropes that we've seen in a lot of video games, sort of giving us a situation that is lush and colorful and beautiful, both because humanity lost. The machines won, and yet the world is pretty. It's interesting to see, to say the very least. I'm excited to see exactly how that story. And I have to say, I'm more excited about this than anything in the big Killzone. Just quite correct, Killzone is a very quality franchise. It just looks like we finally found like a super original thing to be passionate about. I'm very excited. Number three is Nier Automata. It's a sequel to an interesting game that mixed a lot of different gameplay styles, RPG type game, and itself with a spin-off from Dragon Quest III, which was afterwards. Nier Automata takes place as the fourth engine of the original Nier, but being the game is being developed in conjunction with Platinum Games, it's probably going to be a little bit more action-oriented than the first Nier. I think that's the intention to create some another platform as far as like Bayonetta and Metal Gear Rising or Ascension, while obviously retaining the idea to make a very hybrid genre of games with RPG at the base. The original Nier is a great game. It's one of those weird titles that is difficult to describe because it's so many different things in one, but it pulls it off. I fully expect this one to be the same, as well as be more streamlined and targeted to play. Number two is Mass Effect Andromeda, which got a couple of strange bits of feedback from its little showing, but as far as I'm concerned, it still looks like one of the bigger things that's going to happen this year. For one, the environment looks very interesting, but what I'm interested in more so is obviously the characters. Any BioWare story is always presented to you with lots of choice, but also lots of personality. It's one of the few games that isn't fully linear, in my opinion, that gives you everything that a linear game gives you. The reason why I still like linear games is because they're the ones that have their personality. But BioWare bucks that trend, and I'll always say, only a few have really figured out how to do the personality part besides BioWare. Even Bethesda having some problems with that, in my opinion. But between Dragon Age and the original Mass Effect trilogy, I don't really have any worries about the story. Hopefully the gameplay elements continue to improve as well. Really haven't seen anything of that yet. Even in the little thing that they showed off, it looked very reminiscent of the original game, but there was no reason to expect that it was going to really disrupt that. Needless to say, I'm very interested and excited for Mass Effect Andromeda. And finally, number one is a game that has been a very long time coming, Persona 5. Let's just go ahead and say that it's been way, way too long. I need to say Persona doesn't even feel like it's the same era of video games. The fact that there's another one coming up almost seems weird. At the same time, I'm really excited for it because I'm a huge fan of Persona 4, and really all the Persona games, particularly for particular 4 fans. Those exist, just so you know. 5 looks to be taking a lot of the battle elements into a modern era while retaining some of the more interesting and fun elements that we've always had from Persona, and I'm very interested to see where it goes. Reviews of the Japanese version are good. People very much like it, and that makes me excited as well. But mostly these games are so full of personality and interesting ideas, despite them being totally absurdist. And I can tell you this right now, I'm going to spend a great deal of time playing it. Couple of bonus games for you. First, Mount & Blade II Vanguard, which is a prequel to the original, and promises some big upgrades, inventory management, and AI, and the Kingdom Hearts Vader Speed Super Style Remake, which is probably the best version of the game that it includes, and allows you to play Kingdom Hearts on the 19th next-gen console. And Storming, Tides of Numenera, the crowdfunded spiritual successor to Planetscape Torment, an isometric callback to the golden age of computer RPGs that promises some new advancements as well. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like and leave me in the comments to talk about it. If you're not subscribed, now's a great time to do just that. A subscription gets you brand new Game Rant videos every single day of the week. We thank you very much for watching this specific video on Falcon. You can follow me on Twitter at FalconZero, and we'll see you next time right here on Game Rant. PC gaming is stronger than ever, and 2017 will definitely be no slouch. I'm Andy the New Guy, and today we're talking about the best new PC games of 2017. And really quick, these are the most anticipated games that you're looking forward to. Unless one of them gets delayed after we make this video, which will be pretty important, but these are PC games that we think are worth caring about throughout 2017. 25 is Ghost Recon Wildlands. Ghost Recon Wildlands is an open-world tactical shooter that's being developed by Ubisoft. And this is the first time a Ghost Recon game is taking an open-world approach, and it's going to feature a day-night cycle, dynamic weather system, and different terrain. And all of this needs to be taken into account when completing your mission. But how you approach completing your mission is really up to you. You pick your own gear, the time of day, and even how you approach your objective. Drive in, walk in, sneak in, or you can even skydive. Now the game can be played solo or with three other friends at all plans that are customized for Ghost. And if you don't feel like running through the main missions, the open world is available for you to explore, and there are even side missions for you to run through as well. I know Ubisoft doesn't have the best track record for releasing games on PC, so hopefully they can figure this shit out for this game. And up next, number 24, we have Mountain Blade 2 Bannerlord. This is a prequel to the first game in the series.